I just want to go viral. YouTube, Snapchat, IG, double tap. Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am Nick Henderson. I know it's been a minute since you've seen me in this capacity. I have had a lot going on in the past like month since you last seen me on YouTube, and I am sorry. Okay? I'm so sorry. But there's been a lot going on, good and bad, but today we're gonna focus on something crazy that happened to me last week. And many of you may already know and be aware, but if you're not, then strap your seatbelt on because we are in for a ride. So I'm ready, let's do it, let's get into it. All right, y'all, so your boy went viral on TikTok. And not to mention, and not just TikTok, the video even surfaced on Twitter, and it went kind of like Twitter viral, you know? There's so many different levels to viral, in my opinion, that like, at first I was very conflicted about what type of viral my TikTok was, but viral is viral, baby, and we viral. Okay, y'all, so let me give y'all backstory. For those of you who have not seen the TikTok, let's take a look at it. I can't be single and have to go out and mingle faces. That's not me. No, no. Some say I need to. Alright, so there you have it. Me being me. Like, literally just being the crazy crackhead that I am. Just kidding. I don't do crack. Now, maybe. No, I'm kidding. So, let me give y'all some context for this video. I've been having this love-hate relationship with TikTok for a minute. Like, I tried to do TikTok when, like, quarantine first happened last year, and I was just like, eh, this ain't really it for me. And I also was just feeling old. I was just like, I don't even know how to work this. Like, this is not even a part of my generation. Like, I felt really old. I felt like a dinosaur. So I basically just left TikTok alone for about a good year. And I would, you know, sometimes log onto TikTok just to watch videos. I did enjoy watching them. Like, I loved it. But as far as me actually creating it, I'm just like, nah. So this year, I set this goal for myself that I would just be more consistent on every platform that I have, because I've gone through a very interesting journey with social media and how I've had to literally take a step back and realize that, like, social media is literally, it's a illusion. Like, we make social media our world, and we start to perform for social media. We start to just live for social media. And I've just been in a space where I've been separating who I really am versus what I do and what people know me as and all that stuff. So this year, I really felt like, all right, this is my time to really just flourish, spread my wings, and just go for it. So like the past maybe couple months, I've just been making TikToks, trying to be more consistent, but not for the purpose of like going viral. Just literally because I'm trying to set goals in my mind and just stick to them. And I was making little videos here and there, and like nothing really was popping off. But I only had like 30 followers on TikTok, by the way. I just want to say that. So most of my TikToks were sitting at 100 some views, maybe 15 or so likes. And I was cool with that. I was content. I'm like, hey, I'm not expecting to become like, you know, an overnight sensation with this, because it took me freaking dang near 10 years just to get 2,300 followers on Instagram. So fast forward to last week, I was getting my hair done. Blake, my stylist extraordinaire, was doing my hair, so we had taken down my braids that I had that we were about to, you know, redo or whatever. So I have, you know, my hair all out, curly and big and all that. And I, whenever I see my hair like that, I always like to just play with it, because I've never had my hair as long as it is now. And for the record, this is all mine, boo-boo. This is all mine. All me. All mine. I've had a couple people like, oh, I thought those were extensions. No love. I had my hair down and I was just, you know, playing around, shaking it. And about like 2 weeks ago, there was this video that I saw on TikTok of this guy. He had braids, kind of like similar to how I wear my braids, but he was like making fun of Demi Lovato. Like just making a joke of just like how extra and dramatic like that era of like Disney stars were, especially Demi Lovato and like all of them. So I was playing around with my hair, flipping my hair around, like making fun of like how all of those Disney girls used to be literally on some just like, I don't know what they was on, but how they was just whipping their heads like that. Just like all, I can't even do it now, my head hurts. I probably still am recovering from that video, but so I'm, you know, making fun of like that video, but then also making fun of just like, you know, Demi Lovato. And then I was like, you know what, Blake, record this. And I just jokingly, you know, made the little video. It wasn't even TikTok that we filmed the video on. It was just literally like my camera, regular phone camera, and we played the music, La La Land in the background, and I was just being goofy, being me. And just for the record, like I have a ton of videos that have never seen the light of day because I like to keep some stuff for me and just to laugh at, look back on, and it's just for fun. So this video initially was just kind of starting off like that. Like I had no intentions on posting it, but then I was like, well, you know, I should post this. So we posted it. Oh, let me just say, we did two takes. So the first take, I was like cracking up, but I was like, nah, let me really go for broke. Let me really do this. So the second take is what I ended up posting, and posted the video. So this is Friday. Posted the video, and maybe within like the first hour, it just had, you know, modest views. Like nothing crazy. Probably had like maybe 100 or so views. Maybe 200, and I was like, oh snap. I'm like, okay, 200 views. And a couple likes, but I was like, all right, cool. Let me just go on with my day, because I had a lot of things going on. Got my hair done, and I think I had like an apartment viewing. I'm also looking for a new home, by the way. So I'll keep you guys updated with that. But yeah, I went to go see this apartment. Then after that, I was volunteering at church. I've been visiting Soul City, which I love, and went to volunteer with the middle school and high schoolers, and that was really cool. So it was probably like a good 4 or 5 hour gap from when I posted the video to when I later pulled up TikTok and was just blown away. So volunteered, had fun, that was great. Then after that, left, and on my way home, I open up TikTok just to casually just like see what the hell's going on. And I see hella notifications. I'm like, oh my God. Like, and Blake was in the car and I'm just like, oh my God. It was literally the most dramatic thing. I was like, oh my God. He's like, what? And I'm just like, dude, like this video is like, I couldn't even speak. I was just like, oh my God, dude. So I just show him. So at this point it was like 5,000 views and like 1,000 likes, and I'm just like, oh my God. I was like, dude, I was like, I'm like, what the heck? So then it just kept going. I'm like, yo, Blake, we about to go celebrate. So I was like, Kim Bar Liquors? Sure. So we went, got a bottle of Patron, came home, celebrated, because also Blake had to finish doing my hair. So came back home. So this is around like 10 p.m. Came back home, you know, made us a little cocktail, and he started doing my hair again, and dude, like, it was at like 100,000 views, and I was literally just pooping my pants. I was like, whoa, what the heck? And it just kept going, and eventually, the next day, it hit like 500,000, and then like, my sister-in-law, Sharon, she's been like telling me like about TikTok, like, you need to be on TikTok, you need to do this, you need to do that. And I was like, girl. And then she like, I think I called her, I was like, Sharon, I was like, oh my God, my TikTok, like, it just blew up, blah, blah, blah. She's like, looking at the video, we're on like FaceTime, she's like, oh my God. She's like, you're gonna hit 1 million views. And I'm just like, yeah, okay. And in my mind, like, I'm not even trying to like have any expectations with this video. I'm just like, I'm so used to being let down when it comes down to social media. I'm like, I do not want to think about anything other than what's happening in this moment. So anyway, fast forward to literally the next day, like, it hits 1 million views. And I was just blown away, just because, like, I was literally just being myself. And it was actually an emotional moment for me to, like, you know, conceptualize. I was like, dang, like, there have been so many times in my life where I felt like, oh, if I do this, if I, you know, release this type of song, or if I dress like this, if I do this, if I do that, like, then boom, that'll be the thing that people will gravitate toward. And I was just taken aback and just overwhelmed in the best way. Like, yo, I was literally just being me, just unfiltered. Like, it wasn't staged. Like, it was just literally me having fun and, you know, happened to capture it, and then I posted it, and then boom, like, 1.7 million people at this point now have watched it. And like, there's almost like 5,000 comments, and I haven't like read through all of them. And I think I'm gonna actually do a YouTube video where I read my TikTok comments, because I actually have another video that got like 80,000 views, and the comments on these videos are always just hilarious. So I think I'm gonna do a video. So if you want to see a video of these comments, me reading the comments, comment below and tell me if you want to see that, okay? But yeah, man, so the whole experience of going viral, like, it actually, to me, gave me anxiety, because I'm like, dang, like, okay, boom, literally overnight, now I have thousands of followers. Like, right now I'm sitting at almost 7,000 followers, and it's just crazy. Like, literally, I went from 30 followers to all these people now looking for new content from me. And it's really just like, oh, great, like, cool. But it's like, dang, I'm starting to feel this pressure, just like, what if I can't duplicate this same success? And then I kind of felt like God was just telling me, he's like, you never have to worry about, you know, duplicating or replicating success when you are just being you. Like, when you're just being you, you don't have to worry about trying to, you know, follow this formula. So, you know, I've had people tell me like, oh, now you gotta be pumping out content, now you gotta do this video again, now you have to do that, now you do that. And I'm just like, you know, I'm just gonna continue to do what I'm doing. And whenever I feel, you know, just led to post a video, anytime there's just organic moments that happen to be captured, I'm just gonna share it. And I'm not about to put this pressure on myself, like, you know, it is what it is. But one of the things that I want to share with you all that has absolutely just been just wrecking me is that, like, there are people waiting on you. And I made a post on my Instagram when I announced that I had hit 1 million. And in that, I was just saying how, like, there are people literally waiting on you. And you meaning, like, everything that you have to offer, everything that you have to bring to the table. And that is that. You don't have to switch that up. You don't have to, you know, doctor it up. You don't have to, you know, finesse it. Just being you will render the appropriate audience and the appropriate just amount of attention and love. And this video for me has been life-changing, and not in the sense of like, oh man, I woke up and, you know, now I'm famous and now I'm rich. Like, no.
Okay, check's not big enough yet.
It was life-changing because internally, it was a moment where it was a shift. And I felt like, okay, God, we're getting toward the things that I know you have said my life is to become. And, you know, influence and followers, fame, all that, like, that's no longer like this, like, just shiny thing to me. Like, it's a component to, you know, the purpose that I will have, and I do have, and none of that excites me like it used to. But this moment really just confirmed to me, like, yeah, like, you've been working hard, you've been doing a lot, and you've been putting yourself out there, but you just being you is your greatest, like, project yet, and that's your greatest success yet. And me being comfortable enough to show that and showcase that, and I, you know, I can be honest and say, even doing this, like, I haven't posted a YouTube video because I've been so just insecure. I've been, you know, going through a lot that has, you know, just stifled my freedom, and this video really unlocked a new level of freedom. And, you know, since the video, I've posted like several other TikToks that obviously didn't hit 1 million, and I'm okay with that. I'm like, yo, I'm not trying to duplicate this success. If it happens, it happens. I know it will. Like, I just know it. But I want everything to just be organic, and I just want things to be from a place of freedom. So I just want to encourage you guys, like, stop waiting on things to be perfect. Stop waiting on, you know, your hair to look a certain way, your clothes to look a certain way, for you to feel a certain way. Like, just be you. Just show up being you, and trust me, that is what people will, you know, honor and, you know, just flock to and just really respect. So, yeah, I am really excited for this journey that's ahead. Like, who knows what this TikTok stuff will unlock, you know. I definitely intend to be consistent more and do more now that I feel a sense of, like, okay, I can do this. I can do this. Like, so I don't know. So if you're not following me, be sure to follow me at @hendersonnick_. It's my handle across all social media platforms. But yeah, follow me on TikTok. Follow me on this journey, because I really feel like, just like YouTube, is really going to stretch me. It's really going to challenge me. And I'm excited. I'm excited to be challenged. I'm excited to reach people that are eager to just connect with people's authenticity, and, you know, and when I say people, me, like, you know, to connect with just me being me. And I'm loving that, because I'm really just like never before, really loving me more than ever. And when I say me, loving me for who I am and not what I do, you know, not the singing, not the dancing, the acting, the fashion, the, you know, the all that, like, I'm just loving me. So that's the story of how I went viral, y'all. Mark my words, it will not be the last time. So if you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. I want to hear from you guys in the comments, so comment below, like, comment, subscribe, all that stuff. Turn the notification bell on so that you stay up to date with everything that I got going on here. I'm going to be more consistent, guys. I have so many videos that have not seen the light of day, that, you know, have been just sitting, but I'm not going to do that anymore. I'm just going to start putting out stuff. But I love you guys so much, and I hope that you all are inspired and you feel a sense of, you know, just motivation after watching this. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Peace.